ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్
రైట్ ప్రిపరేషన్ మెథడ్స్ ఆఫ్ సైనైడ్స్ అండ్ ఐసోసైనైడ్స్ అండ్ నెక్స్ట్ మెథడ్ ఈజ్ ఫ్రమ్ ఆల్కైల్ ఐసోసైనైడ్స్ ఫ్రమ్ ఆల్కైల్ isocyanate R N double bond C double bond O from alkyl isocyanate on treatment with triethoxyphosphine it is given by isocyanate R N C plus ట్రైఈథాక్సీఫాస్ఫరస్ ఆక్సైడ్ పి డబుల్ బాండ్ ఓ సి టు హెచ్ ఫైవ్ ఓకే దిస్ ఈజ్ ఐసోసైనేట్ ఫార్మేషన్ ఓకే అండ్ వన్ మోర్ మెథడ్ ఈజ్ ఫ్రమ్ ఎన్ ఆల్కైల్ ఫార్మమైడ్ ఫ్రమ్ ఎన్ alkyl formamide from n alkyl formamide here n alkyl formamide is RnHCOH this is n alkyl formamide this n alkyl formamide on treatment with P4O10 or Al2O3 dehydration takes place, it gives RnC less water. Okay, this is isocyanate formation. Similarly, carboxylic acids from carboxylic acids. Carboxylic acid RCOOH on treatment with ammonia NH3 it gives RCOONH4 now it is on heating amide formation RCONH2 dehydration takes place and further P2O5 here also dehydration takes place, it gives RCN, alkyl cyanate. And another one is aldoxymes RCH double bond NOH, aldoxymes with acetic anhydride AC2O. Or thionyl chloride SOCl2 dehydration takes place it gives cyanide plus water okay so these are the preparation methods of cyanides and isocyanates right then go for what are the chemical properties of cyanides and isocyanates. Okay, chemical properties of cyanides and isocyanates. Chemical properties of cyanides and isocyanates. Chemical properties of cyanides and isocyanates. Here chemical property cyanides upon hydrolysis reaction, water upon hydrolysis H2O. First chemical property is hydrolysis. Okay, hydrolysis. So hydrolysis of cyanides and isocyanates. First of all, alkyl cyanides upon hydrolysis, 2 moles of water. This alkyl group carbon is converted into acid, RCOOH, carboxylic acid, RCOOH, remaining ammonia, NH3. Okay, so cyanides, hydrolysis, carboxylic acid formation and ammonia, NH3. Okay, this is cyanides, hydrolysis. Isocyanates, hydrolysis. Here isocyanide hydrolysis or N triple bond C hydrolysis H2O. Okay, hydrolysis, water, H2O water gives rise to, here this isocyanate nitrogen is converted into amine or NH2, primary amine formation, or NH2, remaining HCOOH, formic acid formation. This is formic acid. Okay, RNH2 is a primary amine and carboxylic acids. Cyanides upon hydrolysis, carboxylic acid formation, ammonia. And isocyanates upon hydrolysis, primary amine formation and formic acid. Okay, this is hydrolysis. Okay, and partial hydrolysis. Second one is partial hydrolysis of cyanides. Partial hydrolysis of cyanides, partial hydrolysis of cyanides. Yeah, partial hydrolysis of cyanides or C triple bond N plus water H2. Oxygen attached to carbon, it becomes R C double bond O, remaining 2 hydrogens attached to nitrogen. This is amide. Okay, partial hydrolysis, amide formation takes place. Amide formation. Complete hydrolysis, acid formation. This is partial hydrolysis of cyanides. Partial hydrolysis. Okay, complete hydrolysis means 2 moles of water. Complete hydrolysis means it is given by carboxylic acid plus ammonia. Okay, this is very very important one. Hydrolysis of cyanides, 2 types, partial hydrolysis and complete hydrolysis. If cyanides undergoes partial hydrolysis, amides formation takes place. If cyanides undergoes complete hydrolysis, carboxylic acid and ammonia formation takes place. Okay, this is about hydrolysis of cyanides and isocyanates. Hydrolysis of cyanides and isocyanates. Next, reduction of cyanides and isocyanates. Reduction of cyanides and isocyanates. Second chemical property, reduction. Reduction of cyanides and isocyanates. Reduction of cyanides and isocyanates. Yes, cyanides reduction, R C triple bond N cyanides reduction with tin plus HCl or H2 by nickel. Okay, it gives RCH2NH2 amines formation. This is especially primary amine formation takes place. Primary amine formation. Similarly, this cyanide is also reduced to primary amine in the presence of sodium ethyl alcohol NaC2H5OH. Same product will be obtained, that is RCH2NH2. Same amine formation. Okay, especially this reaction is called as Mendius reduction. It is called as Mendius reaction. This reaction is known as Mendius reaction. It is a Mendius reaction. Okay, cyanides reduction. It is a cyanide reaction. What about the isocyanide reduction? RNC. Isocyanide reduction. Isocyanide. Now, isocyanide reduction with tin plus HCl or lithium aluminum hydride or metal plus HCl. Okay, tin plus HCl or H2 by nickel and sodium amalgam. It is given by RNH and CH3. Okay, RNH, CH3. This is secondary amine formation. Cyanides reduction, primary amines formation. Isocyanide reduction, secondary amine formation. Okay, so these are the reduction properties of cyanides and isocyanides. And another one, reaction with Grignard reagent. And one more reaction, Stepan's reaction. Stepan's reaction. What is Stepan's reaction? Alkyl cyanides on treatment with SnCl2 plus HCl. Okay, in the presence of SnCl2 plus HCl, cyanide is converted into imine RCH double bond NH. Imine. Okay, imine further hydrolysis. Imines further hydrolysis. This is called as imine. Imine further hydrolysis, here breakage of the bond, it is converted into aldehyde. So, formation of aldehydes. So, cyanides converted into aldehydes in the presence of SnCl2 and HCl. Intermediate compound is imine. Imine further hydrolysis, aldehyde formation. Okay, this is Stepan's reaction. And another one is a reaction with Grignard reagent. Yes, here Grignard reagent is alkyl magnesium halide or MgX. Now, alkyl magnesium halide or MgX on treatment with cyanides RCN. What about here? Alkyl group of Grignard reagent is added to the cyanide carbon and these pi bonded electrons are shifted to magnesium. It gives RCR double bond N MgX. Okay, this is the intermediate compound. Now, for this intermediate compound, hydrolysis hydrolysis, breakage of the bond, it is converted into ketone or COR. So your final product is ketone formation. Okay, so cyanides reduction with SnCl2HCl aldehyde formation, and cyanides with Grignard reagent ketone formation takes place. Okay, ketone formation. And another one is, what is the oxidation of cyanides and isocyanates? Oxidation reaction. Oxidation reaction, alkyl isocyanates are NC. Alkyl isocyanates are oxidized with mercuric oxide HgO to form alkyl isocyanates. Alkyl isocyanates. For example, if you take methyl isocyanate CH3NC in the presence of HgO, methyl isocyanate formation, methyl isocyanate formation. But cyanides, there is no oxidation with mercuric oxides. Only isocyanates are oxidized to alkyl isocyanate. For example, if you take methyl isocyanate is taken, it is oxidized with mercuric oxide to form a methyl isocyanate. But cyanides are not oxidized with HgO, mercuric oxides. Okay, so what is the main difference between cyanides and isocyanates? Cyanides and isocyanates are functional isomers. That is the first thing. Cyanide and isocyanates are functional isomers. Okay, cyanide, it is a pleasant water. Isocyanate is a pungent water containing compound. Pungent water, pleasant water. Okay, pungent water means disagreeable water. Isocyanate is the highly toxic when compared to cyanide. Isocyanate is highly toxic when compared to cyanide. Okay, cyanides, pleasant smelling compound, pungent smelling compound, disagreeable water, highly toxic when compared to cyanides. Okay, these are the main important chemical properties of cyanides and isocyanates. Right, what are the distinguished tests of amines? Okay, distinguished tests of amines. Distinguished tests of amines. Distinguished tests of amines. Okay, first one is carbyl amine test. Carbyl amine test. Second one is nitrous acid test. Nitrous acid test. Okay, and third one is Lieberman's test. Lieberman's test. And another one is para nitroso test, and the fifth one is bromine water test. Bromine water test. Bromine water test. Okay, carbylamine test and nitrous acid test, Liberman's test and para nitrous test. So these are the important distinguished tests for the identification of amines. Okay, identification of amines. And another one is also azodine test. Sixth one is azodine test. Okay, these are the distinguished tests of amines. Okay, first one is carbylamine test. Carbyl amine test. Okay, carbyl amine test. Yes, based on this test, we can identify the only primary amines. Okay, primary amines, secondary amines, tertiary amines. Here, primary amines are positive isocyanate test, positive iodoform test. Secondary and tertiary amines are negative. Okay, primary amines positive, secondary tertiary amines are negative test. Here primary amines are especially both aliphatic and aromatic primary amines. Both aliphatic and aromatic primary amines. Amines are given by isocyanate test. Isocyanate test. Okay. Only aliphatic and aromatic primary amines are given by isocyanate test or carbylamine reaction. Secondary and tertiary amines are negative tests. Okay, already you know, if it is aliphatic primary amine or NH2, this is aliphatic primary amine. Okay, it is on treatment with chloroform CHCl3 in the presence of base. This primary amine is converted into isocyanate RNC. If it is aromatic, C6H5 NH2, this is aromatic, which is on treatment with chloroform in the presence of base, it is also given by isocyanate NC. Okay, aliphatic primary amine, this is aromatic primary amine. It is a aliphatic primary amine. Both aliphatic and aromatic primary amines are respond to carbylamine reaction or isocyanate test. So formation of isocyanate. For example, if you take here methylamine, methyl isocyanate formation, here aniline, phenyl isocyanate formation. Okay, this is carbyl amine reaction or isocyanate test. Okay, and another one is nitrous acid test. Nitrous acid test, second one is nitrous acid test. Okay, nitrous acid test. Right, aliphatic and also aromatic. Aliphatic, aromatic, secondary amines. Aliphatic and aromatic secondary amines are given by yellow oily N-nitrous compounds are produces. Yellow oily N-nitrous compounds are produces with nitrous acid HNO2. Okay, aliphatic and aromatic secondary amines. Aliphatic and aromatic secondary amines are given by yellow oily N nitroso compound. But your primary and tertiary amines, primary and tertiary including aliphatic and aromatic amines are negative test. Okay, aliphatic and aromatic primary tertiary amines are negative test for nitrous acid. Negative test means they are not produces yellow oily in nitrous compound. No, there is no formation of, there is no formation of yellow oily compound. There is no formation of yellow oily compound. Only secondary amines produces yellow oily N-nitrous compound. Now for this reaction, alkyl group and hydrogen, this is aliphatic secondary amine. Now this aliphatic secondary amine is treated with nitrous acid HNO2, removal of water, it gives yellow oily N-nitrous compound plus water. Okay, this is yellow oily N-nitrous compound. Similarly, aromatic secondary amines are also produced by yellow oily N-nitrous compound on treatment with nitrous acid HNO2. Here also removal of water, it is given by yellow oily N-nitrous compound. This is also yellow oily N-nitrous compound. That means only secondary amines are given by yellow oily N-nitrous compound. Primary and tertiary, they are not produces yellow oily compound. It is the second identification test of amines. Okay, and third one is Lieberman's test. It is also useful for the identification of secondary amines. Lieberman's test is given by only secondary amines. Third one is Lieberman's test. Okay, Lieberman's test. In this, only secondary amines positive, only secondary amines are positive. So N-nitrous yellow oily, especially here secondary amines on treatment with nitrous acid HNO2 gives rise to yellow oily N-nitrous yellow oily N-nitrous derivative. This yellow oily N-nitrous derivative further reacts with NaOH. It is given by blue color solution. Okay, here formation of blue color solution. Okay, only secondary amines on treatment with nitrous acid to give yellow oily N-nitrous derivative. This yellow oily N-nitrous derivative further reacts with sodium hydroxide, blue color solution formation. But in the case of primary and tertiary, there is no formation of blue color. So therefore, primary and tertiary amines, primary and tertiary amines are negative test, means there is no formation of blue color. Okay, negative test means here there is no formation of blue color, no color formation, there is no color. Okay, no color means negative test for Lieberman's test negative primary, secondary, primary tertiary amines are negative for Lieberman's test. Yes, then go for next one is para-nitroso test. Para amines, aromatic tertiary amines on treatment with nitrous acid HNO2, okay, gives rise to para-nitroso derivative. Para-nitroso derivative formation. Para-nitroso derivative. Now this para-nitroso derivative further reacts with base. It gives parrot green color solution. Parrot green color solution formation. Parrot green color. So that is nothing but aromatic tertiary amines only. Only aromatic tertiary amines are positive para-nitroso test. Remaining all are negative test. Okay, only aromatic tertiary is positive. Remaining primary and secondary, all these are negative para-nitroso test. Okay, what is the para-nitroso test? Aromatic tertiary amines reacts with HNO2 nitrous acid to form para-nitroso derivative. This para-nitroso derivative further reacts with sodium hydroxide, parrot green color solution. Okay, aromatic tertiary amine means like this. This is aromatic tertiary amine. It is a aromatic tertiary amine. Now this aromatic tertiary amine reacts with nitrous acid, gives rise to para-nitroso derivative. Here NN dialkyl at para position NO2. NN para-nitroso derivative. It is a para-nitroso derivative. This para-nitroso derivative further treated with sodium hydroxide NaOH, it is given by parrot green color. Formation of parrot green color indicates aromatic tertiary amine. This is para-nitroso test. And after that, bromine water test. Bromine water test. Only aromatic primary amines gives bromine water test. Only aromatic primary amines. Bromine water test. The fifth one is bromine water test. Bromine water test. It is given by only aromatic primary amines. Okay, bromine water test is given by only aromatic primary amines. Okay, aromatic primary amines decolorizes the bromine water. Decolorizes the bromine water. Only aromatic primary amines decolorizes bromine water. Okay, bromine water, it is a red color, blood red color, non-metallic liquid. bromine water. It is a red color non-metallic liquid. Red color non-metallic liquid. Okay, bromine water is a red color non-metallic liquid. So this red color is decolorized by aromatic primary amines, but not aliphatic amines. So for this reaction, for this test, reaction is aromatic primary amine. Best example is aniline. Okay, this is aniline molecule. Okay, now this aniline on treatment with bromine water. Okay, bromine water. Now this bromine is attacked by at all the active sites. Okay, NH2. Why? Because this NH2 group is the electron donating group. Presence of electron donating group, your electrophile is attacked at ortho position and para position. Bromine water is highly reactive. Therefore, these bromines are attacked at all the active sites of aniline. Therefore, it gives tribromo aniline. NH2 bromine and bromine. Here it is bromine. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 2, 4, 6. Tribromo aniline. Okay, 2, 4, 6. Tribromo aniline. So aniline is converted into 2, 4, 6 tribromo aniline. Here 3 moles of bromine is taken, 3 moles of HBr is obtained. Byproduct is 3 moles of HBr. So this bromine water is highly reactive. It is highly reactive. Bromine water is highly reactive and red color solution. Red color solution. The red color becomes colorless due to the formation of 2,4,6 tribromo aniline. Okay, this is bromine water test. Okay, bromine water test is given by aromatic primary amines. So aromatic primary amines are decolorizes the bromine water. Bromine water color is red color, non-metallic liquid. This red color non-metallic liquid is added to the aniline aromatic primary amine. It is aromatic primary amine. This aromatic primary amine decolorizes the red color of bromine. So and forms 2,4,6 tribromo aniline and HBr. Okay, this is the bromine water test. And another one is azo dye test. Azo dye test. The another one is azo dye test. Azo dye test. Phenols and aromatic amines. Phenols and aromatic amines. Phenols and aromatic amines are given by azo dye test. Given by azo dye test. Phenols and aromatic amines are given by azo dye test. Here especially aromatic amines. Okay, aromatic amines. Okay, aromatic amines reacts with diazonium salt, benzene diazonium chloride or diazonium salts in the presence of acid. Aromatic amines with diazonium salts in the presence of acid, it is given by yellow color dye. Okay, so that means here only aromatic primary amines with diazonium salts to produce yellow color dye. But other amines, aliphatic amines negative azodiatest. Okay, aliphatic amines negative azodiatest, including phenols, are also gives azodiatest. Right now, your aromatic amines, best example aniline C6H5NH2. This is aniline molecule. Now this aniline is treated with benzene diazonium chloride, N2 plus Cl minus. It is benzene diazonium chloride in the presence of acid like H plus. This benzene diazonium ion is attacks at pair of position of aniline. This is C6H5NH2, N double bond N, and this is C6H5. This is called as para amino azobenzene. It is a para amino azobenzene. This para amino azobenzene is a yellow color dye. Okay, yellow color dye. But other amines are not given by yellow color dye. Okay, this is example one, aromatic amines. In this aromatic amine, these two hydrogens are also replaced by methyl group. Two hydrogens are replaced by methyl group. This is dimethyl amine. Same functioning, dimethyl amine with benzene diazonium chloride, N2 plus Cl minus. In the presence of acid, it gives dimethyl, NN dimethyl. Here N CH3 group, here CH3 group, and N double bond N, and this is C6H5. So it is also a yellow dye, yellow color dye. Okay, so only aromatic primary amines are given by yellow color dye. Other amines are not respond to azodye. In this, phenols are also given by azodye test. Okay, phenol C6H5OH phenol with benzene diazonium chloride C6H5N2 plus Cl minus in the presence of base. Because of phenol is a weak acid requires basic medium. Aniline is the base, it requires acidic medium. Right, phenol with benzene diazonium chloride, it is given by para hydroxy azobenzene. Okay, this is para hydroxy azobenzene. Formation of para hydroxy azobenzene. It is a orange red color dye. This is orange red color dye. Okay, this is exceptional case. So azodye test is given by phenols and also aromatic amines. Only aromatic amines are respond to azodite test and produces yellow color dye. Other amines are negative test. Okay, this is about nitrogen compounds.